Herman's Military Antiques. Ah, oh, that brings back memories. I think I mentioned this before, but like, the entire point of this game is really just to engender nostalgia and quotes.
Who cares? Video games are so late 90s. Illegal fireworks are all the rave now. Better make it snappy, though, if you want to be part of this trend.
Okay.
Fine by me.
Illegal fireworks.
Eat my dust, dust eaters.
I mean, Bart really has to remember that. Yeah, kind of understandable Kearney might not be into video games considering he's like in his 30s. That was a weird reveal when they revealed that Kearney was actually an actual old man. Not old man, but he's a man. Who's just been held back that many times. But then the funny bit for that came when they revealed Kearney's son, who also goes to Springfield Elementary, and that was fun. Hey, Otterman.
Finest quality Chinese frog launchers, please.
Here you go, 2 kilos of Chinese sky candy. They'll blow you away.
Okay. Isn't Moe's supposed to be like opposite a music place? I'm not gonna be able to do anything with that while I'm on a mission, unfortunately. Alright, let's go. Wait, what? Oh, go into Moe's. Alright. I completely blanked then, I wasn't even paying attention. Hey, Mo. Oh, the love tester. Oh, that's classic.
Sorry, Bot. I can't serve booze to a miner. It ain't right.
I'm here to buy fireworks.
Oh, hell yeah.
So we're just getting fireworks from, like, a bunch of people? Panda Chow. Those weird little side businesses that Moe's had over the years. Great. Like that one, the X-Files crossover they did that had Mulder and Scully. And Moe just has an orca in the back room. It's like, what? It turns up later again when you see Mo just carrying the orca across a field where Homer happens to be with Mulder and Scully. It's great.
One dozen of your best Tijuana toilet crackers, my good man.
Here you go, kid dude. Now don't blow your hand off. Or do. What do I care?
I don't know, Snake. What do you care? I feel like the camera's being really awkward with me today. Where am I going? There was an interesting video that came out recently on Did You Know Gaming about the cancelled sequel to this. Sounded kind of interesting. It's kind of a shame that they never did anything with this. It's like, this is a solid enough game, but it has its limitations. Chief Wiggum is right there.
Ralph, word in the hood is that you got access to your old man's fireworks stash.
Fireworks make my ears yell.
Here's some gumdrops.
El Barto.
Now make with the works.
My daddy's going to put you in jail.
Ralph, you traitor.
Fireworks, eh? You're looking at 5 life sentences of community service.
Uh-oh.
This is bad, this is bad, this is bad.
I think I bit my
tongue. I bent my Wookiee.
Sweet as a cheese Danish.
Oh, what was I saying? Yeah, it's like, this game has potential. It's enjoyable, but at the time it came out, it was the best Simpsons game. Some people would argue it's still the best Simpsons game.
Whoa, wicked.
But particularly in this day and age, it exists mostly for nostalgia. Nostalgia for the game, nostalgia for the series. and there's a neat curiosity more than anything else. But the sequel sounded like it was going to really do some proper open world Grand Theft Auto style stuff. Like, not like the A-team rated stuff, but like Grand Theft Auto through the lens of The Simpsons.
Hey, Jabba the Fat, do you know where I can get a copy of Bone Storm 2?
Yes, I have no time to converse with you. I must be the first to register my disgust on the internet regarding the new McBain film. The action was dismal, and the nudity was frustratingly fleeting. I barely got going.
Quick, to the Fat Mobile! No.
Yes, I suppose, but must we call it that?
Yeah. I mean, Pizza the Hut would be a better joke, but... You know, Spaceballs already did that.
Time for some road rage, Bart Simpson style. Yeah, I totally rule!
Hey, the Tower of Popsicles. Popsicle sticks.
What's my name? Booyah!
Direct hit! I need more power!
Wait, is this supposed to be like, It is. It's supposed to be a parody of the, Star Trek fight music.
Well, that just got a bit more rare.
Woo! Nice one!
This car control's terrible.
I'm happy to report that your quest for Bone Storm 2 is quite futile. Professor Frink posted a message on my newsgroup, alt.furryanimals.fanfiction.net, that he has bought up all the remaining video games.
Oh.
Well, thank you not to moan in my mid-sized vehicle.
Perfection, thy name is Bart.
The actual Simpsons characters look pretty decent, but then you've got characters like this who are just nobody. And they look terrible. Where's my car? Most of our doctors have degrees.
This is Bart Simpson requesting one.
We'd kind of like you not to talk about Dr. Nick. Flammable means the same thing as inflammable? Inflammable means the same thing as flammable? What a crazy world we live in. Let's get that. Ha! We'll need this for costumes. Where are the costume shops? I think there's three costume shops in each level. They all sell the same costumes. There's three costumes per level. I think there's three places you can buy them. Like in the first level is the Quickie Mart. But there are other ones. I think the school had one as well. But I don't remember where they are for this level. Alright, let's get the, card.
I'm flying.
There we go.
Temporarily flying.
The crusty pregnancy test. Oh, that caused problems.
I gotta play Bone Storm 2. Give me one.
No can do, my pointy-headed friend. I need the power of video game violence to run my latest invention slash monster. If you find me a World War II communication radio and a satellite, then my creation will live, and we can play with it and enjoy the frolicking.
Oh, cool. Real violence is way better than TV violence. It's like a level boss come to life. Now, who would have a World War II radio? That guy that sells all those grenades to Nelson might, I better check.
Herman sells grenades to Nelson?
You got it.
I feel like we keep going to characters voiced by Hank Azaria.
Yeah.
Like, so many of the characters we've been to recently have been voiced by Hank Azaria. I thought it was supposed to be out. I thought it was supposed to be racing that van. I completely forgot that it said follow it. So yeah, the black vans that had satellite dishes in the first level now have cameras on them. It's a weird plot point that never means anything. After the first level, the black vans are just kind of there and nobody talks about them. It's not even a weird plot thing later, it just stops after the first level where it's revealed they're a pizza company, and that's it.
being here before.
Whee! Gotta be careful not to go too far ahead, or you will actually lose them. Come on. Should have known that'd happen. God, I used to throw these levels inside and out. I played this game so much. Oh wow, Snake and the Little Bandit. That's gotta mean something. Hey Chief Wiggum, you didn't get tied up in Herman's basement again, did you?
Hey, Springfield's lamest, what's the deal?
Didn't you hear? Herman's been robbed. Hey, you don't know who did it, do you? Because if you did, boy, that would be great.
Oh, no. Now where am I going to get a radio?
These fresh skid marks leading away from the scene of the crime could be a clue. But who's to say, really?
Yeah, that's another Hank Azaria character. Why's my car all the way over there? Why would Snake steal a radio? Out of all the stuff Herman has, why a radio? Also, I guess that explains why we saw Snake driving away from the crime scene. Because none of the characters appear in cars unless there's some kind of story thing going on.
Hey Snake, what's up?
Do I know you, little dude?
I need that radio you borrowed.
No way, little dude. This radio is going to help me score beaucoup de chicks.
What?
Last time I checked, chicks like fast cars, not vintage electronics. Why don't we race for the radio?
Oh, I totally agree to your proposal.
Yeah, let's race Snake's muscle car in our soapbox racer.
Don't forget to ride. I hope that was expensive.
I feel like there's a... there's a step of logic we've missed here. Oh well. No, Lionel Hawks. He won't appear in this game. They retired him after the tragic death of his voice actor Phil Hartman.
Don't have a cow, man.
Same with Troy McClure, they were both voiced by Phil Hartman. And he tragic death. They retired both characters out of respect for him.
Oh, this is too cool for school. Oh,
so you know you're watching a classic episode if it has Lionel Hutz or Troy McClure in. I could have won that if I hadn't crashed.
Oh my god.
Well, at least the restart's fast enough.
Bart Simpson at your service.
Oh, you've got to be kidding. No. Well, I'll see you guys when we get back to the race with Snake.
PlayStation 2, rated E for everyone.
Hey Snake, what?
Alright, we're back at the race. Let's do it better this time.
Yeah, I totally rule.
That's definitely something that I'm not overly fond of. Fail the last part of the mission, restart the entire mission. Grand Theft Auto was bad with that back in the PS2 era. Seriously. Indicate. And again. Now, Grand Theft Auto was bad with that. Multi-step, like multi-layered missions. Where if you fail any of it, you have to restart it all.
This is one weird play.
I think there was one exception to that in the PS2 era. It was the last mission of San Andreas.
Now to find a satellite dish. Who has those anymore? I know. Like trash.
Well, thanks for just giving it to me, Snake. You know, I find that pretty amusing. Cricket explanation, cricket match. The cricket match goes for 4 hours, and then they have a second explanation. It's like, I'm English. Cricket is one of the national sports. I don't understand cricket. It goes on for days. I don't get it. And before anybody wants to tell me about it, I don't really care either. Not a sports guy. Well, extreme sports are kind of fun. But even then, that's more because of video games than anything. Why do I like Tony Hawk's games? Well, why do I like skateboarding Tony Hawk's games? Same's true of a lot of stuff. So, particularly with the recent Star Wars stuff. It's made me remember the main reason why I actually liked Star Wars in the first place. It's like I like the movies and everything, but the main reason I really got into Star Wars was the games.
Hey there, Mr. Slackjawed Yokel.
That be I.
Can I borrow your satellite dish?
Sure, if you help me scoop up my flat meat, sophisticated city youngster. Those darn revenuers don't like me selling roadkill.
A poo's trying to grab the roadkill. Yeah, I can believe that. But yeah, like, the games are why I like Star Wars. Like, really like Star Wars. And since Disney bought Lucasfilm and gave the exclusive license to EA, like, we just don't really had anything worth playing more than anything else. It's like Jedi Fallen Order came out recently, and I played that, and it was okay. That's kind of it, it was okay. It had a lot of problems. Frame rate issues, glitches, bugs. I think it crashed on me once. It was okay, but you see the Metacritic score is like 81, I think. Because I played it on Xbox One. Metacritic's like 81 for it. I'm like... But it's kind of meh. The only reason I finished it was definitely because of it being Star Wars. Without it being Star Wars, I thought it was kind of meh. And I feel like the bar has been set really low. Because, like the last single player Star Wars game was Force Unleashed 2. You know, that wasn't a great game. And since then, all we've had are the two Battlefront games that EA's put out. I've heard Battlefront 2's gotten better, but that's mostly, that's talking pretty much entirely about its multiplayer. And I'm not overly into multiplayer anyway, not for extended periods, not out keep playing multiplayer. Well, I escaped from a poo because he got stuck. You can see it on the map. There we go.
The burgers are made of roadkill? That explains the tire tracks.
Take this satellite dish as a reward. She gets 14 channels, including the outhouse channel. Man, I love watching that.
Thanks, inbred hillbilly.
Torrent nothing.
Camera weirdness.
And sound. Give it up for America's bad boy.